Well, the new IRS chief hammered by a House committee today about why he reinstated bonuses, even as his agency is being investigated for targeting conservative groups. So what's going on? David Bossi, he's the president of Citizens United, and he joins us now with more. Thank you for joining us, first of all. And my first question to you is, what can the IRS do to reestablish trust with the American people?
Well, I think the IRS commissioner is just out of touch with reality. He's out of touch with the American people. Look, what the IRS did was unconscionable. The American people don't trust the IRS, and now all of a sudden, without congressional notice or approval, he's just by his single hand reinstating these bonuses. I think it's an outrage, and I think Congress needs to act upon it. Cut his budget.
Now, he says that he wants to reestablish trust, but at the same time, David, it's still unclear, and some would say she's not going to, in fact, whether Barbara Bosserman, who is a lead investigator for the Department of Justice, will be allowed to testify. If you want to reestablish trust, why not allow her to testify, even though she is controversial for donating over $6,000 to President Obama's campaign in 2012?
Well, first of all, there's a couple of things. One is Barbara Bosserman knows better. She is a lawyer, understands the rules as a lawyer, as a prosecutor. She should be recusing herself. She shouldn't be waiting on Eric Holder or anyone else. She should recuse herself for having donated $6,000 to Barack Obama's campaign. That is the appearance of impropriety, the appearance of a conflict of interest should just negate her in her own mind, and she should do that for the good of the investigation. And so I think that that's the first thing that has to happen.
I'm going to throw another name out to you that, you know, this reminds people of, Lois Lerner. What about her?
Yeah. Well, let me just say this. Lois Lerner came and testified and tried to use the Fifth Amendment. And she tried to claim that she had a Fifth Amendment right of self-incrimination. But she then ended up giving some testimony, and that's now called into question. So I think they're worried about what can she say versus what she can't say. During the 1990s, when I served as the chief investigator for that very committee, we called in Louis Freeh, the FBI director, Janet Reno, the attorney general, numerous line prosecutors, numerous independent counsels for testimony before our full committee. When they could not answer a question, they simply didn't, and they told us why. It was not a problem. But to say with a blanket that this a prosecutor cannot come and testify is outrageous, and it goes against the very precedents of the Clinton administration and Janet Reno.
You know, in President Obama's interview with Bill O'Reilly, he used words like a bonehead decision-making, said it was not a smidgen of corruption, but yet on the same count, they say the investigation continues. So where do we go from here?
It's interesting, Heather. How can the president say on one hand there's an ongoing investigation, actually multiple ongoing investigations, yet he can definitively state that there's nothing going to come from them? That is very upsetting to the conservatives on the committee. That's why they're asking these tough questions. But it also brings into question Barbara Bosserman's objectivity. If she's a donor and she's a supporter of Barack Obama, does Barack Obama understand in the back of his mind that there's nothing going to come from it?
All right. Thank you so much for joining us. And at the same time, reinstating those bonuses. We appreciate it.
Thank you.